The effects of the current drought are pretty dire. We have records going back over 20 years, and the well levels that we're seeing right now are lower than they've ever been in the history of the district. We've seen most all of our springs dry up this summer. In fact, all of the rivers and streams in the Hill Country are seeing zero flow somewhere along their path. This is really dangerous because we don't have any surface water flow, which of course affects our ability to go swimming and recreate. It also affects downstream businesses who require surface water for their water needs. Jacob's well is very interesting because the water comes out and creates Cypress Creek, which flows through downtown Wimberley and then rejoins the Blanco River, which flows downstream and then disappears into the Edwards Aquifer. It's a natural spring that's flowed forever. Until recently, it's began to stop flowing during drought. This is wholly attributable to overpumping in the area.
There's a lot of people that use Jacob's Well as a place to swim. There's ecological resources, all kinds of little critters that live in around the springs and downstream and Cypress Creek before it gets to the Blanco River. And then all the various businesses and landowners that have property along Cypress Creek. So we're trying to study the aquifers here, the Trinity aquifers in this area, to better understand, well, how does the water get from rainfall to spring discharge and everything in between? Because besides spring discharge, people use the Trinity aquifers out here. That's the main source of drinking water in this area, whether it's just a private well that someone has for a ranch or their house, or it's a larger supply well that feeds into a big neighborhood. We've installed two wells. Of course, the West Bay Multiport well here on this Coleman Canyon's reserve property, and then just about 2,000 feet south of here on Jacob's Well Natural Area property, we've installed a second well. Together, these two wells will tell us a lot about the aquifers in this area that feed into Jacob's Well that ultimately feed into the Edwards Aquifer.
The Trinity Aquifer actually has three distinct layers, and it's important to get isolated and individual information out of each one of those layers. The beauty of a multi-port well is it gives us the ability to isolate different layers of the aquifer so that we can see if one is in jeopardy or in trouble, we can manage that resource and move some of the pumping to another level that has maybe better quality level or more water to pump.
This basically tells us the health of the aquifer, not in terms of water quality, but in terms of pressure and how much water is in the aquifer. So we're going to be looking at what is that combined effect of drought and pumping, and where does that leave the aquifer?
The Texas Water Development Board provided funding for sample analyses for the Jacob's Well study. We will additionally be housing that data in our groundwater database and making this available to the public and stakeholders. It is important to understand the quantity and the quality of groundwater and how it moves through aquifer systems so that informed decisions can be made to manage this important resource for future generations.
Science is critical to the district because it gives us a lot of information about the aquifer that we never do in the past.
As the state's population continues to grow, groundwater will only become more vital.